all through my life, I've found little places to live. And when I was a kid, I always built like tree houses and climbed trees and built forts. And you know, when I first walked into Lizzie Bell and looked her over, I was like, this is the perfect fort. For me, I think what's more important than having a big house is having a space that makes me feel good. I've just been able to make it my own. And she has so much character and so much history, and I couldn't ask for anything else. Someone could see me now, let them see you. The first time I did a single-handed crossing, I was sailing off Puerto Rico, and I remember there's something like emotionally going on with me that I had tears in my eyes. I couldn't believe after 2 years I was finally doing my first single-handed sail in the Caribbean. I think I'll remember that moment for the rest of my life. Even counting sheep, don't help me sleep. Being alone is being in the middle of the ocean, and there's nobody for 40 miles in each direction. And if there's a problem, you are on your own. So I always talk to the boat. You know, we're going through some storms. I'm always like, ah, Lizzie Bell, you got this one. You know, this is what you're made for. You know, we get through it together. And through the really bad stuff, I always just give her a kiss at the end and say, you know, thank you. Because, you know, it feels good to get out of that storm into a nice safe harbor and drop your anchor. This life is long. So you wouldn't be wrong. Free and free. One of the things that I always remember about my grandfather was that he always carried a knife. He always had it, and he was ready to deal with anything that it could be used for. He took a lot of pride in the knife that he gave me. He always showed me how sharp it was, and we cut the fish up, and he was like, this is a knife. This is a really well-built knife. And I started wearing it on my hip. And you know, a lot of people always ask me, why are you wearing that knife? You wear it everywhere. You're in the pub, and you're walking down the street. It's not just when you're on Lizzie Bell. And I really think that, you know, I don't always admit it, but I think that I'm kind of carrying on, like, you know, who he was, and that makes me feel good. You know, I think it gives me more of a purpose to be on Lizzie Bell, is to maintain. And she is my home, so my money, instead of paying rent, goes into making sure she's safe and the upkeep is there. Yeah, it makes the money, and it only makes so much money. I think it's funny that my friends all say that they're making money. I think I understand money in my way of understanding money, which is, well, once you figure out how to make enough, then go do the things that make you happy. There's always a way to make money. There's always a way to live. I have enough to go and have a beer, and I have enough to go to the grocery store. I can put enough diesel in the tanks of the boat, and I think I'm one of the richest people in the world. I feel great. We all need a little bit of money to live, but some of us take so much. If people think I'm a dirtbag, then people think I'm a dirtbag. If you think I'm a dirtbag, then you don't understand the lifestyle. And then that's okay with me too. What am I gonna call them, a clean bag? So when I take a bath once every 2 days, maybe three, who knows? It's just a little bit different, but for me it's a minor change. I think it's been 2.5 months since I had a freshwater shower, so I feel pretty good. I eat to get full at this point. And, you know, there's important things like fruits and vegetables. I make sure I eat that stuff, because that stuff is cheap. But then, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I eat a lot of canned food, a lot of corned beef and tuna and stuff like that. And that's for the reason Lizzie Bell doesn't have a fridge. You don't need a refrigerator. You can get along without it. And maybe it makes you enjoy that really cold bottle of water when you do get the chance. Thank you. think there's lots of things to do on land at night and go to the club and meet people and stuff like that. And that's the way it was kind of in the first couple weeks, and then you kind of get burnt out and you start to realize that it's really more about watching the sunrise. I think that being part of the ocean and living down here is about, you know, it's like camping. You go to bed when the sun goes down, and when you get up is when the sun comes up. Nowhere else in my life have I ever lived by those parameters. Sun goes down every day at home. I don't know. I never sat there and watched it. I certainly never watched the sun come up. So I guess it's the different places that you are and what you're doing makes you appreciate those things. Maybe.
Oh, hot sand on toes, cold sand in sleeping bags. I come to know that memories were the best things you ever had. The summer shorn, beat down on bone and back. So far from home where the ocean stood, down dust and pine.
That's a touchy subject for me. significant others. I guess I have a fear that if I commit myself and bring someone on the boat, and that they're not going to like the lifestyle, and that I'm going to love having them there, and they're going to leave. And at this point, I'm so far away, I can't leave the boat. I have to finish what I started, and if I have to do it by myself, I guess that's the way it has to be done. And I think maybe that's a problem. You know, maybe that's something I gotta deal with, and that's where I am right now. I think.
As the old pine fair we sang.
I'm in a really good place, and I'm learning lots, and I'm challenged every day. And every day I'm learning something new. I think that that's why it's important that I do this kind of stuff, is that so I look back in 20 years and be like, wow, I'm sure happy I did that. That was worth $1 million in my bank account. And no, maybe I'll be content when I'm ready to go. I don't really know what I'm doing next. I don't know where I'm going from here. And you either go to Brazil, and once you go down that road, that's a long way home. The next one is go Colombia, maybe cross the Panama Canal. Cross the Panama Canal, all the trade winds go to Australia. But, you know, imagine being on the boat for a month and a half and only having 2 days of ice. That's a big decision to make. And then the next is head back up the islands. Start heading home, and I'm not sure that I'm ready to head in that direction yet.